Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. We are from Group 5, offering GBL. We will present Chapter 13, Building Information System. Group 5 members consist of myself, Adam Rehan Sarika, Aditya Alifi Zani, Ahmad Ndaru Kiswara, Baruna Firjatullah, and Muhammad Hira Ananda. This is the learning objective of Chapter 13. Our time today has to do with building information systems. How to building information systems in an organization? The goal is to increase revenue, increase the profit of the organization itself, changing the system from what was previously manual to integrated management information systems to increase the effectiveness and efficiency of the organization. As we know, companies for their survival need to keep up with the times. System differs in terms of their size and technological complexity and in terms of the organizational problems they are meant to solve. A number of systems building approaches have been developed to deal with these differences. Structural organizational changes enabled by IT. Information technology can lead to organizational changes. There are four types of changes. First is automation, which replaces manual tasks and increasing efficiency. Second, there is rationalization of procedures, means that procedures change to be simpler and less complicated. Third is business process redesign through analyze, simplify, and redesign business process can also go through reorganized workflow, combine steps, eliminate repetition. Fourth and last is paradigm shifts, define new business model or changing the nature of organization. Risks and rewards. The most common forms of organizational changes are automation and or rationalization. This is slow change and moderate rewards, but comes with small risks. There is also changes that is fast and comprehensive. It is redesign and paradigm shifts, which are fast and offers high rewards, but also have high risk. Business process management. Many businesses today are trying to use information technology to improve their business process. Some of these systems entail incremental process change, but others require more far-reaching incremental redesign of business process. To deal with these changes, organizations are turning to business process management. Business process management, or BPM, is an organizational discipline where a company takes a step back and looks at all of these processes in total and individually. It analyzes the current state and identifies areas of improvement to create a more efficient and effective organization. BPM provides variety of tools, methodologies to analyze, design, and optimize process. BPM is used by firms to manage business process redesign. Steps in business process management. First, identify process for change. Second, analyze existing processes. Third, design the new process. Four, implement the new process. Five, continuous measurement. This slide's graphic illustrates the process of purchasing a book prior to re-engineering, including the steps if a book is not available. It emphasizes the sequential nature of the tasks. Besides the time taken for this process, the chance when error happens is quite higher too. We can see if a customer wants to buy a book, they need to go to a bookstore, and then they need to search shelves for the book they want. Is the book available? If yes, then customers can purchase the book and take book back home. What is the book not available? Then product searches in the storage. If they found it, they bring it to the customers so they can purchase it. If the clerk hasn't found the book, the clerk will inquire about ordering. Is it able to order? If no, then the customer need to go to another store. If it is able to order, then the clerk need to place order for the book that customer want. And then after that, the clerk will receive the book several days after. And then the clerk will notify customers. The customers can return to the store to purchase the book. and this is redesigned process for purchasing a book online. This graphic illustrates the book purchasing process after re-engineering as an online process. The new process and technology has reduced number of stages to 4 or 5.
My name is Aditya Alivizani. The second learning objective is what are the core activities in the system's development process? First one is about system analysis. System analysis is the analysis of a problem that a firm tries to solve with an information system. It consists of defining the problem, identifying its cause, specifying the solution, and identifying the information requirements that must be met by a system solution. Normally, the system analysis process identifies several alternative solutions that the organization can pursue and assess the feasibility of each. A written systems proposal report describes the costs and benefits and the advantage and disadvantage of each alternative. Establishing information requirements. Perhaps the most challenging task of system analysis is to define the specific information requirements that must be met by the chosen system solution. Some problems do not require an information system solution, but instead need an adjustment in management, additional training, or refinement of existing organizational procedures. If the problem is information related, system analysis still may be required to diagnose the problem and arrive at the proper solution. Next is system design. System analysis describes what a system should do to meet information requirements, and the system design shows how the system will fulfill this objective. The design of an information system is the overall plan or model for that system. Like houses or buildings, information systems may have possible design. What makes one design superior to others is the ease and efficiency with which it fulfills user requirements within a specific set of technical, organizational, financial, and time constraints. Next is the role of end users. The role of end users, user information requirements drive the entire system building effort. Users must have sufficient control over the design process to ensure that the system reflects their business priorities and information needs, not the bias of the financial staff. Working on design increases users' understanding and acceptance of the system. Next one is completing system development process. The remaining step in the system development process translate the solution specification established during system analysis and design into a fully operational information system. This concluding step consists of programming, testing, conversion, production, and maintenance. And the last one is completing system development process. There are core activity and description in the system development. First one is system analysis to identify the problems. Second one is system design to create design specification, and then programming to translate design specification into program code, and then testing to perform unit testing, and then conversion to plan conversion, and last one is production and maintenance to operate the system, evaluate the system, and modify the system.
Then what are the principal methodologies for modeling and designing system? The first one is structure methodologies. Structure development methods are process-oriented, focusing primarily on modeling the process or action that capture, store, manipulate, and distribute data as the data flow through a system. The primary tool for representing a system's component process and the flow of data between them is the data flow diagram, or we call it DFD. The data flow diagrams offer a logical graphic model of information flow, partitioning a system into modules that show manageable levels of detail. It rigorously specifies the process or transformation that occur within each module and the interfaces that exist between them. And this is the example of data flow diagram on mail in university registration system. As we know, the verify availability in number one is the process. Enroll student and confirm registration is some of process too. And then the name and content of each of the data flows appear adjacent to each row. There is one external entity in the system, it is the student, and there are two data stores, the student master file and the course file. The second example is object-oriented development. Object-oriented development uses the object as the basic unit of system analysis and design. An object combines data and the specific process that operate on those data. Data encapsulated in an object can be accessed and modified only by the operations or methods associated with that object. Instead of passing data to procedure, programs send a message for an object to perform an operation that is already embedded in. And the system is modeled as a collection of objects and the relationship among them. Because processing logic resides within objects rather than inspired software programs, objects must collaborate with each other to make the system work. Object-oriented modeling is based on the concept of class and inheritance, objects belonging to a certain class or general category of similar objects have the feature of that class. Classes of object in turn can inherit all the structure and behavior of a more general class and then add variables and behaviors unique to each object. New classes of object are created by choosing an existing class and specifying how the new class differs from the existing class instead of starting from scratch each time. And the last is computer-aided software engineering. Provide software tools to automate the methodologies we have just described to reduce the amount of repetitive works the developer needs to do. KISS tool or computer-aided software engineering tools also facilitated the creation of clear documentation and the coordination of team development efforts. Team members can share their work easily by accessing each other's file to review or modify what has been done.
What are alternative methods for building information systems? Systems differ in terms of their size and technological complexity, and in terms of the organizational problems they are meant to solve. A number of system building approaches have been developed to deal with these differences. Traditional systems lifecycle. The systems lifecycle is the oldest method for building information systems. The lifecycle methodology is a phased approach to building a system, dividing systems development into formal stage. The systems lifecycle methodology maintains a formal divisions of labor between end users and information system specialists. Technical specialists such as a system analyst and programmers are responsible for much of the system's analysis, design, and implementation work. End users are limited to providing information requirement and reviewing the technical steps work. The life cycles also emphasize formal specifications and paperwork, so many documents are generated during the course of a systems project. the traditional systems development cycle. The systems development life cycle partition systems development into formal stage, with each stage requiring computations before the next stage can begin. Prototyping. Prototyping consists of building an experimental systems rapidly and inexpensively for end users to evaluate. By interacting with the prototype, users can get a better idea of their information's requirement. The prototype endorsed by the users can be used as a template to create the final systems. The prototype is a working version of an information system or part of the system, but it is meant to be only a preliminary model. Once operational, the prototype will be further refined until it conforms precisely to users' requirement. Once the design has been finalized, the prototype can be converted into a polished production system. Steps in prototyping. Step one is identify the user's basic requirements. And step two is develop an initial prototype. Step three is use the prototype. And last is step four, revise and enhance the prototype. The process of developing a prototype can be broken down into four steps. Identify basic requirements, develop a working prototype, use the prototype, and revise and enhance the prototype. Advantage and disadvantage of prototype. Prototyping is most useful when there is some uncertainty about requirements or design solutions and often used for designing an information systems and user interface. Because prototyping encourages intense end user involvement throughout the system's development lifecycle, and it is more likely to produce systems that fulfill users' requirements. However, rapid prototyping can gloss over essential steps in system development. If the completed prototype works reasonably well, management may not see the need for reprogramming, redesign, or full documentations and testing to build a polished production system. End user development. End user development allows end users with little or no formal assistance from technical specialists to create simple information system, reducing the time and steps required to produce a finished applications. On the whole, end user developed systems can be completed more rapidly than those developed throughout the conventional systems lifecycle. Application software package, software service, and outsourcing. Today, many systems are based on commercially available application software package or cloud software as a service or SaaS. Many applications are common to all business organizations. For example, payroll, accounts receivable, general ledger, or inventory control. For such universal functions with standard processes that do not change a great deal over time, a more generic system will fulfill the requirements of many organizations. If a commercial software package or cloud software service can fulfill most of an organization's requirements, the company does not have to write its own software. The company can save time and money by using the pre-written, pre-designed, pre-tested software programs from the software vendor.
If a firm does not want to use its internal resources to build or operate information system, it can outsource the work to an external organization that specializes in providing these services. cloud computing and software as a service providers are one form of outsourcing. Subscribing companies use the software and computer hardware provided by the service as a technical platform for their system. In another form of outsourcing, a company could hire an external vendor to design and create the software for its system, but the company would operate the system on its own computers. The outsourcing vendors might be domestic or in another country, but the domestic outsourcing is a driven primarily by the fact that outsourcing firms possess skills, resources, and assets that their client do not have. What are new approaches for the system buildings in a digital film era? In the digital film environment, organizations need to be able to add, change, and retire their technology capabilities very rapidly to respond to new opportunity, including the need to provide application for mobile platform. Companies are starting to use shorter, more informal development processes that provide fast solutions. In addition to using software packages and online software services, businesses are relying more heavily on fast cycle techniques, such as rapid application development, joint application design and agile development, and reusable standardized software component that can be assembled into a complete set of services for e-commerce and e-business. Here's the three explain of rapid application development, agile development, and DevOps. The first one is rapid application development is used to describe the process of creating workable system in a very short period of time with some flexibility to adapt as a project evolves. Second is agile development focuses on rapid delivery of working software by breaking a large project into a series of small sub-projects that are complete in short period of time using iteration and continuous feedback. Last one is DevOps builds on agile development principles as an organizational strategy to create a culture and an environment that further promote rapid and agile development practices. Next, okay. Compound-based development. It enables a system to be built by assembling and integrating existing software components. Increasingly, the software components are coming from a cloud server, web services, tools for building new information system, application or changing existing system. Okay. Web services can perform a certain function on their own, and they can also engage other web services to complete more complex transactions, such as checking credit, procurement, and ordering products. The last one is mobile application development, an internet-enabled app with a specific functionality for mobile device. Users access mobile app through their mobile website web browser. The web app is resides primarily on the server. It accessed via internet and doesn't need to be installed on the device. The same application can be used where most devices can surf the web regardless on their brand. Thank you.